the results of our comparative effectiveness research inform the decision maker. The decision maker in Germany, this is the Federal Joint Committee, decides whether a certain drug or intervention or structure or operation or diagnostic procedure improves health of patients necessary to maintain health or to improve health. This is the first aim. The second aim is to improve patients and also to inform doctors so that they can make the best decision. The aims are twofold. First of all, we have to prevent damage to the patients. We have to take care that no harm is done to patients. And if we do not know that something is beneficial, then there is always the risk of harm. So we shouldn't do new interventions in patients when we do not really know that they are more beneficial than harmful. This is the first aspect. The second aspect are the costs. So if something is expensive and not necessary, not beneficial, then the damage is done to the solidarity system because it's paid for and not necessarily paid for. In the beginning, we were not allowed to assess cost-effectiveness or cost-benefit relations with regard to drugs, but now it changed in 2007 and we are now addressing also this issue. But we are doing it in a two-step method. First of all, we analyze the benefits, the clinical effectiveness, without considering the costs. And if a new device or a new drug is not better than the comparator, we do not have to assess the cost effectiveness because if it's not better but more expensive, it's clearly inefficient. The problem of cost effectiveness relation evaluation comes up when something is better, when we have additional benefit. Then we put into relation the additional benefit, the additional clinical benefit, with the additional cost.